So, I had something on my mind that I wanted to get off.
My chest real quick.
It's about taking things for granted in life. I just wanted to take it a chance. Have everybody sit back and think of all the things they are grateful for instead of being, you know, all negative about. I'm grateful that I have an opportunity to finally own my own home. Yeah, I may be 28 years old, but I went through some pretty shitty things in my life. I didn't have the ideal parents growing up. My parents weren't doctors or lawyers or executives or nothing like that. As a matter of fact, I ended up becoming a ward of the state at 11 years old and going to live with my aunt at a very young age with my brother and my sister. So anything I've ever had in life, I've been fairly appreciative of. I work very hard for everything I own. The TV, like the TV in front of you, it's only 37 inches, but I own it, you know. I don't owe anybody anything for it. Matter of fact, I actually own 3 high-definition TVs. One, which is up in my bedroom, and the other one's going to be up in our attic when it shows up. We have a nice wooden attic. All remodeled. It's like actually the nicest place in the house, but I'm not going to take you up there right now. I want you to consider things about life. Be happy and ecstatic that you didn't have to grow up. Some of you, maybe some of you did, didn't have to grow up being picked on or bullied. I feel bad for those who have, because it sucks. In elementary school, I used to get suspended a lot because I would get beat up. I'd have to fight back. It sucked because of my weight problem or whatever. I tried to be respectful of everyone that comes across. But if you do cross me the wrong way, you know, I can be a prick, just like anything. I want you to sit back and think about how what you do may affect someone else. Just think about that one little insult, what it might do to that other person. Would you want to be insulted like that? Would you want to feel like you're this tall, you know? It's not good, man. I'm not a hippie or nothing. Don't take me that way. But I think that in a lot of ways, people take life too seriously. I try to enjoy life as much as I can. I don't know when my life is going to end. Most of my family members, they kick the bucket 60s, you know? And I'm 28, so that, according to my family, you know, I'm like, my life's half over. That's not something I want to look forward to. I mean, you may not, okay, for instance, you may not be for the war, or whatever, for whatever reasons, what you are, but I've had 2 friends. First, Lucas James Williams, right out of high school, he went overseas, 18 years old, and he was killed when his Humvee flipped over. 18 years old, didn't get to enjoy a full life. And I volunteer every year for Lucas J. Williams Foundation at the Haunted Forest. It's located in Vermont, Bakersfield, Vermont, where I grew up. So if you ever get a chance, please come on up, take a trip up during Halloween, and come see me perform in their haunted forest. I do it every year. Have it's past 6-7 years since they've been having it. my other one, my other buddy, AJ, he died over in Afghanistan, roadside bomb or something, and he never got to see his baby be born, or to hold his daughter, or anything like that, or whatever, you know. That's like, that poor little small child is going to grow up without a dad, you know. And he was a cool kid. AJ was, you know, do anything for anybody. And now, gone. Just like that. So, appreciate your life. Appreciate everything. I mean, I collect the stuff like I collect with the basketball cards and stuff like that. Yeah, I might not get the greatest things in every box, but I appreciate that I get the opportunity to open them. The opportunity to do whatever in life. I have the opportunity to own this three-story Victorian house with stained glass windows and a fly trap. Excuse the fly trap. That's something that my mother and my father, they don't own their own homes. They have to rent still, and they're in their 50s, and they don't own as much as I do already. So, just take a chance, man. Seriously. Respect other people. Hope, you don't have to necessarily be religious like I am. But don't knock other people for what their religious beliefs. I don't care if you're Muslim. I don't care if you're Jewish or, I don't know, Buddhist. I'm not trying to insult anybody, or Muslim or whatever. I don't care. But I'm not going to disrespect you for your beliefs. I don't want people to disrespect me for my beliefs. Just try to respect other people. I don't know. I don't know what got me going about this tough subject. Maybe it's because I finally starting to realize my dreams. I've been with my wife. We've been married 2 years. Been together 6. We don't have any children. And I see these people that have pop out kids left and right, live off government's dollar, and I can't stand that, man. They don't give a shit about their kids. I'd love to hold a child in my arms, you know. So just be thankful that you may do better than me in life, or you may not, but just be thankful for what you have. Thankful that you get to live every day. Thankful that we're not in the 1800s or whatever, being prosecuted for our beliefs, or can't say the color of our skin, because there's still some scum out there that will hate another person because of what they are, and that's just fucking wrong. Grow the fuck up. That's all I gotta say. I don't care what you look like. I don't care who you are, man. If you're decent to me, I'd gladly let you into my home. Feed you a meal, you know, give you the world if I had it. Because that's the way it should be. It should be fucking trying to help your neighbor out. Alright, just take that into your thoughts. I'm rambling on, but I just want everyone to know. You know, be thankful of what you have in life. Okay? Hopefully I'll have another video up as soon as we get the stuff moved in here. You can see my shit. Alright. Peace and love to all my brothers and sisters out in the YouTube community, and thank you for watching my video, as long as it may have been.